Hello everybody, I want to show you today something that I learned about Buildroot and how to build a Buildroot image with Qt5 and external toolchain. I wrote a document here that show exactly what I did. And the idea is that I can build a Qt5 and run it using a Linux buffer on the Raspberry Pi 3. So here's the build root, and I'm using the 64 dev config, 64 bit, starting from make Raspberry Pi 3 64 dev config. This is the initial, and let's go over the settings that I did. In target option, I didn't change anything. As I said, it's 64 bit, and we know this is Cortex-A53. This is the Raspberry Pi 3. Build option, I just change the save build config in case I want to save it in a different configuration, using make save dev config, and it will be saved here, and I can, for example, upload it to GitHub. And change the download dir to a common place that will help other builds to use the same downloads area. I didn't enable the compiler cache. I don't know, I saw that if it doesn't work, I need to do make clean. Sometimes we get, you know, errors that are just, we cannot even understand why those errors are coming. And in this case, we should do make clean and make again. Commands, toolchain. Okay, this is something that I wanted to do. I want to, if we were going to use Buildroot toolchain, it will take Buildroot a lot of time to download, compile the using the cross tool and G, the toolchain, and it can take up to 1.5 only the toolchain. It took me on my computer, and it's a strong computer. So Buildroot toolchain internally is something that we want to avoid. External toolchain it's good, but we have in this tutorial, I downloaded and installed the Buildroot what I wanted to do, I want to install the toolchain using the cross tool ng, and for the Raspberry Pi, there is already a configuration ready for the Raspberry Pi 3. But there is one thing that I did, that it came with 4.10.8, the Linux kernel, and I changed it to 4.9.20 because the Raspberry Pi kernel is 4.9, so it's good to match them together. Previously, when they wasn't matched, which mean that the Linux kernel in the toolchain was 4.10 and the Buildroot kernel headers, I told him here it was 4.9. I got kernel panic in it, not initialized or something. I don't know if it's really related, but it's good to match them together. So in external toolchain, after the toolchain has been created, in this tutorial I will not show you how to do it. But once you installed, it's very easy if you follow the CrossToolNG documentation and you install a toolchain. And it will install in my place, it installed it on username, xtools, arch, this is the path. Note that it without the minus at the end, also without the binary the bean folder. And the prefix is without the minus, without the anything, just the name of the compiler. And this is when you will take a crosstool-ng compiler, it will generate this compiler for the 64-bit compiler. Also, it's good. It's important to provide that it is a C++ support, and also this should be enabled. System configuration. We have the option to change the host name and bizu. This is important because we want to use in slash dev. We want to use libinput. If you want to use libinput for the mouse, we need to use dynamic EUDEV, and this will give us the ability to enable a libinput. So libinput is enabled. You can see here, libinput is enabled. This is in both of the mouse. Okay, we already continuing now. In the Mesa, I enable the software software video drivers. In the 64, by the way, in 64-bit, the OpenGL, the VC4 driver from Broadcom, it's not enabled because for some reason it required, and the VC4 driver required only the 32-bit. It's it need BR2 ARM and not ARC 64, so it required only the I will need to investigate it right like this. So we have the software driver. See, I don't enable the OpenGL because in this tutorial, what I want to use the Qt5 Linux driver. The Qt has four. Several plugins that you can use: the Linux Frame Buffer, EGLFS, DirectFB, and Wayland. I'm using here the Linux Frame Buffer. So I enable the GUI module and also enable the compile and install examples because I want to check immediately if it was working. I don't enable OpenGL, of course. The default graphic platform is Linux Frame Buffer, which is here, and enable TSLib, and that's it. I don't need anymore. For Xorg, I enable some drivers. I just enable everything. What we need here is the libinput, the EVDev, and also the FBDev drivers, and that's it almost. Text editor, I like to enable the Joe editor, and for file system, in case because we are adding the Qt5, it will increase the file system size, so we need to add some block size. If you want the exact in mega, you can go to the internet and check for block to a block size to mega and mega size to block, but if you want, just increase it a little bit, and it's past the compilation. So that's it what I added for the Qt5. Some notes, let's see. Everything is documented here. Okay, so when I run it, I did run make. It took some time, and we see that the examples are located in user lib Qt examples on the target on the Raspberry Pi 3. This is example that I took a snapshot of one of the examples, and a note that I flash it with the Itcher, very nice tool that is create the SD card and create the partition according to the SD. Everything is okay. Each year will format the SD card for you, and we make sure that you are not destroying your dev SDA unless you are in a safe mode. Okay, this is the libraries. And okay, so what else you can install? A Drawbear. Okay, this is a SSH, a minimalistic SSH that you call, and that's it. After I installed it, I managed to see the video buffer and play with Qt. So next time we'll try the OpenGL and maybe on the 32-bit. Thank you very much and have a nice day.